The Grace of God is for me, April 5. By the grace of God I am what I am, and His grace which was bestowed upon me was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me. 1 Corinthians 15:10. There are those who attempt to ascend the ladder of Christian progress. But as they advance, they begin to put their trust in the power of man and soon lose sight of Jesus, the author and finisher of their faith. The result is failure, the loss of all that has been gained. Sad indeed is the condition of those who, becoming weary of the way, allow the enemy of souls to rob them of the Christian graces. The love of God in the soul will have a direct influence upon the life, and will call the intellect and affections into active, healthful exercise. The child of God will not rest satisfied until he is clothed with the righteousness of Christ and sustained by his life-giving power. When he sees a weakness in his character, it is not enough to confess it again and again. He must go to work with determination and energy to overcome his defects by building up opposite traits of character. He will not shun this work because it is difficult. Untiring energy is required of the Christian, but he is not obliged to work in his own strength. Divine power awaits his demand. Everyone who is sincerely striving for the victory over self will appropriate the promise, "My grace is sufficient for thee." Through personal effort, joined with the prayer of faith, the soul is trained. Day by day, the character grows into the likeness of Christ. It may cost a severe conflict to overcome habits which have been long indulged, but we may triumph through the grace of Christ. If we are true to the promptings of the Spirit of God, we shall go on from grace to grace and from glory to glory until we shall receive the finishing touch of immortality.